Good morning, students. Now we will discuss congruent figures and area of the congruent figures. So see children, congruent figures. Two figures are called congruent if they have the same shape and the same size. Two figures are called congruent figures if they have same shape and same size. Then we can say that the figures are known as congruent figure. Now we will discuss area of the congruent figure. So see children, question number 1. This is the figure number 1 and this is the figure number 2. It is square with side length 5 cm. It is also square, side length of 5 cm. Means both are square and their side length is 5 cm. So area of this square 1, 5 multiply 5, 25 cm square. Area of square 2, 5 multiply 5 is equal to 25 cm square. So see children, this is the square 1 and this is the square 2. Both have same side length 5 cm. So we can say that both square are congruent figure. And they have same area also. See children, area of square 1 is 25 cm square and area of square 2 is also 25 cm square. So see children, so what is the conclusion for example number 1? If two figures are congruent, then they have same area. If two figures are congruent to each other, then they have same area. For example, square 1 and square 2, both have same side length 5 cm, 5 cm. So, they are congruent square. Or we can say that they are congruent figure. And their area is also same. See, here area is 25 cm square. Here area is 25 cm square. Means both square are congruent to each other and they have same area and it is 25 cm square. So final conclusion is, if two figures are congruent, then they have same area. And it is statement number 1. What is statement number 1? If two figures are congruent, then they have same area. So now see children, converse or reverse of statement 1 is not true. This is the statement 1. But its converse or reverse statement is not true. See, if two figures are congruent, then they have same area. Now its reverse statement or its congruent statement. See, if two figures have same area, then they are congruent figure. This is not true. See, if two figures are congruent, then they have same area. It is true. But its opposite statement, if two figures have same area, then they are congruent to each other, it is not true. This I can explain with the help of the example number 2. So see children, in example number 2, one square with side length 6 cm, one square is given to us, its side length is 6 cm. One rectangle is given to us, its length is 9 cm and breadth is 4 cm. In example number 2, one square is given to us, its side length is 6 cm. One rectangle is given to us, its length is 9 cm and breadth is 4 cm. Now we will identify their area. So see children, area of the square is equal to side multiply side. Here side length is 6. So 6 multiply 6. 6 6 are 36 cm square. Means area of the square is 36 cm square. Now we will identify area of the rectangle. So area of the rectangle formula is length multiply breadth. So area is equal to length multiply breadth. Length is equal to 9, so 9, multiply then multiply. Breadth is equal to 4, then 4. So 9, 4 is 36. So area of the rectangle is equal to 36 cm square. So see children, area of the square is 36 cm square and area of the rectangle is also 36 cm square. Means both figure have same area, but they cannot have same shape and same size. See, it is the square and it is the rectangle. They cannot have same shape and same size. So statement number 1, opposite statement, is not true. What is the opposite statement? If two figures have same area, then they are not congruent to each other. See, square area is 36 cm square, rectangle area is also 36 cm square, but they are not congruent to each other. So what is our final conclusion? If two figures have same area, then they cannot congruent to each other. This already I explained with example number 2. Again I am explaining to you. It is the square. Its area is 36 cm square. It is the rectangle. Its area is also 36 cm square. Both have same area, but they cannot congruent to each other because they have different shape and size. So see children, this is the normal explanation of congruent figures. I hope you can understand this. Thank you.